Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In this video, we will finally fetch the items from the API and we will display it to our complex recycler view that has multiple view types. So let's do it. Now in this video, we will work on our main activity and home view model. So we already have everything set up. We have the view model, we have the binding set up, we also have set the layout manager to our recycler view. Now what I will do here is I will create adapter. So I will write here private val adapter equals to home recycler view adapter. Now I will set this adapter to this recycler view. So here I will write adapter equals to adapter. I think I should change the name of this adapter, so I will write home recycler view adapter like this, and I will use this adapter to set it to our recycler view adapter like this. So we have everything set up. Now what we need to do is we need to get values from the APIs, and we will do it inside home view model. And I already have created a function where I will fetch the values for my home recycler view, and I have a live data that is of type list of type home recycler view item. And whenever we will initialize our view model, I will call this function and it will fetch all the items from the API. So let's do it. To get the items, I also have the repository here and I will use it to get the items. As we have suspending functions inside our repository, we need to use a coroutine scope. And because we are inside a view model, I will use view model scope to launch my suspending functions. So first, I will post a loading state to my home list items live data. So I will write here home list items live data dot post value, and here I will write resource dot loading. I also have created a sealed class to define different resource states, and those are loading, failure and success. So we have the loading state. Now we need to hit two APIs, and both the APIs are independent from each other, and that is why we can execute those requests parallelly. So what I will do here is I will write val movies deferred to get the movies list first. So we have movies deferred equals to async, and I will call repository dot get movies like this. The same way I will call directors deferred equals to async and repository dot get directors like this. Now from these defers, I will get movies and directors. So here I will write val movies equals to movies deferred dot await, and val directors equals to directors deferred dot await. Now finally, I will check if movies is resource dot success and directors is resource dot success. To make the code simple here, I have used this case. That means if both the API calls are success, then I will show the list view or recycler view. And for any other case, I will consider it as failure. But you can be more specific in handling error cases. I am doing like this because it is just an example. Now I will create a val home items list, and it is a mutable list of home recycler view item. Now I will add an item to this home items list. So what I will do is I will add home recycler view item dot title, and for the first parameter I will pass 1, and for the next parameter I have recommended movies like this. Then I will add all the movies list that we get from the API. So I will add all movies dot value, because movies is a resource and we need to call the value, or we need to get this value property to get the list of movies. And I have defined it inside the sealed class. As you can see, we have this value that we are getting here. Now the same way, I will add one more title. So again, we will use home recycler view item dot title, and I will write top directors. And we also need to pass ID, so I will pass 2. Now we will add all the directors. So again, we will use directors dot value like this. Now finally, I will post this list to my home list items live data. So here I will write home list items live data dot post value, and I will write resource dot success and then home items list like this. And for any other case, I will pass resource dot failure. For now, I will just write it is not a network failure. And I will also pass null for the error code and error body. But you can be more specific in handling errors. So we have our view model ready. And now we will come back to our activity. And whenever we will initialize our view model, we will hit this get home list items function, and this function will fetch the movies and directors, and it will give us a combined list of home recycler view items, and we will observe it using this home list items live data. So let's do it. I will write here view model dot home list items live data dot observe. For the lifecycle owner, I will pass this, and then I can pass a trailing lambda that will have the result. Now here I will write when result, and again it is a sealed class, so I can easily generate all the remaining branches. So first we have failure, then we have loading, and then we have success. In case of loading, I will show the progress bar. So here I will write, actually I do not need this curly braces. So I will write binding.progressbar.show. And in case of failure, I will hide the progress bar. So we have binding.progressbar.hide, and you can handle your failure case here. In case of success, I will hide the progress bar, and then I will get the list from the result and I will add it to my adapter. So here I will write home recycler view adapter dot items equals to result dot value, and that's it. Now our code should work. So let's run the application and see whether it is working or not. So you can see our list is working absolutely fine. And this is only a single recycler view with multiple view types. So this is how you can create complex lists for your application. So thanks for watching, everyone. In case you have any problem, question or confusion, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. And finally, if you like this video or if you like this course, then please hit on that like button, subscribe to my channel and share this video with all your friends. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Belal Khan now signing off.